It's Monday and we are at the beginning of a brand new unit, which is Community Helpers. This would be unit 9, week 1, and as always, we are going to be using simple and basic activities that will help build a foundation of math, English, and science skills for your child that they are going to carry on with them throughout their school and the rest of their lives, really. Most of the resources we use you will find lying around your house, and if you don't have exactly what we're using, it's very easy to substitute for something that you have or that's appropriate for you and your family. This unit was designed to help your child to understand about different jobs in the community and how important these jobs are and how they help us in our day-to-day lives. So this unit is going to open up the opportunity for a lot of dramatic play and pretending, which you're probably doing a lot of this already anyways, as playing doctor or pretending to be a fireman or a policeman and things like that. And we just really want to take the opportunity when we are out and about, when we see these things going on, to point out how the community helpers and workers are working within our community. I will be sure to list the supplies and books that we are going to use for this week in the description box below. And if you have just stumbled upon this video, I will also link our playlist of homeschooling right from the beginning on Unit 1, Week 1, in case you want to start from the beginning, or perhaps if you're just looking for some great activities to do with your kiddos. So for Monday, you're going to start, as always, with your morning circle time or calendar routine, along with the poem and song for this unit, which I will include a screenshot of. And this is a really great song because you can really work this into your activities and make it a game all on its own. Then we're going to introduce the topic of community helpers and some of these community workers and helpers that you would see within your own community. Then we're going to get into today's read aloud, which is helpers in the community. As always, you're encouraged to do a picture walk through this book first before you do an actual read aloud and try to guess with your child what is happening on each page. Then we're going to get into our learning activity, which is classifying and sorting tools, followed by our easy activity, which is to draw a job. Let's do this. We started out Monday. I had the learning activity on the table, and before we got into that, we actually did go through our book, which just started the whole conversation of community and people who work within our community and the types of workers that we see in our community all the time. So we watched this book once through. So for this activity, you were to get a tray and collect a bunch of different items that would pertain to a certain community helper or worker. So you may get a toy school bus, a fire engine, a police car, a hammer, a toothbrush, a stethoscope, things like that. And then you're going to grab these items and ask your child who would use this or vice versa, you know, just kind of figure out how the tools and items that you have in your tray would correlate with a community helper or worker. So we got out our tray and right away Nola was pulling things out and telling me who uses these kinds of things. So I would just simply ask her who uses a stethoscope or who uses a toothbrush, who drives the kids to school, and she would pull out the coordinating item. And then we talked about these people in our community and talked about the few people that we know that have community jobs. Then a little later on, we got into our easy activity, which is to draw a job. Nola was a little unsure of how to do this. When we started to set the scene, she wasn't really sure what she wanted to be. So I just simply started asking her, could you draw me a fire truck? Could you draw me a police car? Could you draw me a school bus? Stuff like that. And she would pick whatever color she thought was appropriate for that and started to make her own drawing on a piece of paper. So we had multiple drawings on one piece of paper. And it is also suggested that once your child is finished this drawing, that you fold it up, put it in an envelope, and mail it off to grandma or grandpa or aunt or uncle or somebody you think would appreciate this picture, just to have your kiddo take part in the whole mailing something process. Now, Nola was not into this at all. She was very possessive of her drawing and wanted it up on the wall, which is exactly where we put it. And I'm not really too concerned because Valentine's Day wasn't too long ago and we mailed cards. Oh, we mailed lots and lots of cards and she took full part in everything. Not too worried about that one. Tuesday! Yes, it really is Tuesday. We just didn't get to this part of the day yesterday, so here we are doing it all on Tuesday. Today, you are to start, as always, with your morning circle time or calendar routine, along with the poem and song for this unit. Then you want to recap and recall yesterday's book, which is also today's read aloud, and see if your child can remember any of the community workers. For our things to talk about today, we're going to introduce the letter H. So you want to have this written in both large and small version on a piece of paper, whiteboard, chalkboard, whatever you've got. And it is a good idea to include a few words that your child knows beginning with this letter. Our learning activity is an alphabet hunt and our easy activity is animal counting. So let's do this. This morning when we started off, we really spent a lot of time on the poem and song today and kind of put a lot of our activities all into that. Nola wasn't interested in reading or watching the book again that we read yesterday, but she could recall a lot of the community workers that were mentioned in that book. And then when we got into our song, we played that probably 10 times over, where this is the format for that song, where you can just change some of the words, the clues, and your child will guess what is the job that you are talking about. And she really, really liked this game. We had a fun time doing it. I thought I would stump her a couple of times, but she knew exactly what I was talking about. We also took some time to go over the letter H in this one, since she had already seen the letter H on the table first thing this morning before we got into anything. She knew that was the letter that we were going to be talking about today. We talked a little bit about it there, but didn't get too far into it. And then we also, while we were going through our poem and song, started our learning activity, which is an alphabet hunt, where you are to go on the hunt, be a librarian, and go through all of your books and find the letter H. Not all of them, but a few, you know what I mean. So we did that in the poem and song, and then shortly after that, we started going through our books. Now, one thing I will say is you want to try to select books that don't have an abundance of words on one page, or that are maybe in a little bit of a larger print, because I found with the first book that we were going through, I could see her struggling a little bit to find an H because there were so many words on each page and the print was quite small. So I made sure that with the second book that we went through, the print was a little bit larger and there wasn't as many words on each page so that she could easily find these letters. Because if it's too hard, they're not going to want to participate anymore. They want to feel like they are achieving. So we went through all in all about 5 books today along with our poem and song looking for the letter H. Now our easy activity is going to be some animal counting. For this activity, you are to pretend that you are the zookeeper. Using masking tape, you want to make about a 10-framed zoo with masking tape on your floor, and this is where the animals live. And then you call out a number and your child will get that amount of animals, put them in the graph, count them out with you, making sure you touch each one and get to the desired number that you have called out or written down on a piece of paper. Now this one we haven't quite gotten to yet. We kind of started it. I just was simply using the magnet animals that sit on the inside of our front door, and we quickly were distracted. You know, we have a 1-year-old that likes to participate too, but sometimes it ends a game quickly. So I'm gonna see if we can circle back to that one, because quite frankly we really haven't finished that one yet today. But that's it for today. Wednesday! Today you are to start, as always, with your morning circle time or calendar routine, and then add in the song and poem for this unit. Then we're going to introduce the book for the day, which is called Whose Hat Is That? As always, you are to do a picture walk through this story first and try to guess what's happening on each page with your child before you do the actual read aloud. 4 our things to talk about today is to do just that. While you're doing the picture walkthrough or while you're reading the book, you want to take some extra time to talk about why people wear these certain types of hats, which this book is really good. It kind of does that for you. Our learning activity for the day is measuring with rulers, and our easy activity is book dominoes. So let's do this. Before I get too far into today's, I will just mention that we never got around to playing the zookeeper game yesterday. It just wasn't happening. She wasn't into it, so I don't sweat that too much. We will try to incorporate it into our activities or day some other time throughout the week. We started out with a little bit of a mix of everything on the table this morning. I had some books set up there along with the ruler, thinking we would kind of intertwine the two, knowing that Nola would probably start measuring the books, and then that would give us a great idea to play this new game with the books where we would get into the dominoes. Before we got too far into that, we did go through the story and successfully did a picture walkthrough again. It was really great to guess what was happening because it doesn't show you the full picture right away. At least it didn't with the read aloud that I found online for this book anyway, so it was a really, really good way to get us guessing to what we were actually seeing. And while we were on our morning walk this morning, we happened to see our mail carrier filling up the mailboxes. We saw some train track maintenance off in the distance, so there was a truck on the tracks instead of a train. And there happened to be some light construction down at the end of our road, so we saw a lot of things happening with community workers today, and that kept the conversation going. The point of this learning activity, measuring with rulers, is not to try to get your child to understand the concept of centimeters or inches. We are just simply introducing the ruler to to them again as another tool that we can use to measure things with, and that there are numbers on it. That's all you really need them to understand. They don't have to be using it correctly or really grasping the full use of this instrument. You just want to have them go around and measure random things in the house as best they can. So we started out measuring some of the books that were on the table. She had measured one of the little eggs from our Easter egg decorations, and then she kind of went about the house measuring, typically measuring about the same things that she had measured last week, I think, when we used the ruler as well. The table, the chair, stuff like that. Once we were done, we had a great idea for a new book game of Book Domino. It's a little bit tricky to get Nola's assistance in setting these books up without knocking them over before we're even set up to go. So we tried this a few times, and then I went upstairs and grabbed a series of books that are all generally the same size. I found that was a little bit easier to make this happen with. And of course, we had the trouble of keeping Colton, the one-year-old, far enough away while we did got this set up as well. But it was great fun. We did this periodically throughout the day. We had set it up a few times and knocked them all down. This was a game that Colton really liked once he got the hang of it as well, and it was really great to have him be able to participate in both of our activities today, even though there's a 2-year age gap. So as we were playing this game, we also talked about who uses books most for their jobs in the community, and she came up with teacher, and then I led her to the answer of librarian through a few clues, and then we also came up with construction worker because we were using these books to build, and construction workers build as well. So it was another great way to keep the conversation going all day long. Thursday. Today you're to start, as always, with your morning circle time or calendar routine. Then we're going to get right into our review topic. And for this review, you simply want to start giving your child clues and asking them questions like, I drive a red truck. I may climb a ladder. I may spray water. I rescue people. Who am I? Go through this a few times for a few different community helpers. Then for today's read aloud, it is just a repeat of yesterday's read aloud. And for our things to talk about, we want to revisit the letter H. Again, you want to have this written in both large and small version on paper, chalkboard, whiteboard, whatever you've got handy, and talk about the sound that it makes and some familiar words that begin with the letter H. Our learning activity is envelope counting, and our easy activity is playing grocery store. So let's do this. This morning I started out with our learning activity on the table. For this activity, you're going to need 10 envelopes, and you are going to number them 1 through 10, and then you are going to have an assortment of little square pieces of paper, or whatever shape you prefer. Square is just easiest to cut out. You want to have enough little shapes cut out to stuff each envelope with the appropriate number. Then your child is going to get to play mail carrier and deliver the mail to family members, perhaps a couple of neighbors, or most likely just some stuffed animals in your house. To help encourage Nola to play along with this game, I had told her that they were little Easter chocolates and we were going to send them to people because Easter is just around the corner and she's very excited about that. So this played out just as I hoped it would. She was counting out the squares and stuffing the envelopes. It took a little bit of direction on my part to get her to count out the squares first and then try to stuff the envelopes, as she was trying to just put it right in the envelope right away and quickly losing count of where she was. All in all, we had a great time doing this activity. We got all of the envelope stuff, and then we just happened to have a little mail carrier bag from a koala crate we have recently got, which was all about the mail, and she went on to deliver these envelopes to her brother, the cat, and mostly some of our stuffed animals. And then, of course, Colton took a turn too, as he usually does when we play these fun activities. Once we had finished delivering the mail, and we were still kind of on the topic of Easter, this is when we took the opportunity to do our letter H review, as we have some decorations hanging around the house, and a lot of them say Happy Easter. So we started to talk about the letter H and some different words than we had previously talked about, and even did a little bit of a mini alphabet hunt around the house to see where else we could find the letter H. For our easy activity, it was completely easy for us. We have a little pretend grocery store game, which Nola had recently asked me to bring up and put in our toy rotation. And this is a great little grocery store game. It is battery operated. There are a few different food groups. There's a little pretend scanner on the side that beeps when you hit it, and sometimes it says, oops, scan again. And however many items you scan, it asks you for the appropriate amount of coins that you then have to put in a little slot, or you can swipe a card. My kids really enjoy playing this game as it revolves around food, which if it involves food, they're in. We took turns pretending that we were each the clerk and providing the groceries and bagging them and asking for coins and pushing all the buttons, and it was a lot of fun. And that's it for the day. And now it's Friday. As always, we start with your morning circle time or calendar routine, along with the poem and song included with this unit. Then we're gonna get into today's read aloud, which is called Community Helpers A to Z. Then for our things to talk about today, you want to do some recall and recap of this book as it is our topic for the week. And you'll wanna ask your child a few different questions, like where do we see community helpers? And what do community helpers do for our community? Our learning activity is to piece together a shaped garbage truck, and our easy activity is to write a thank you letter. So let's do this. This morning we started out with the learning activity on the table, so you'll want to prep a couple of different shapes so your child can glue them together to make something that resembles a garbage truck. So while you're doing this activity, you want to take time to talk about the shapes and what has four corners and four sides or doesn't have any corner. You also want to talk about being a sanitation worker and what that involves and what it does for your community. For the easy activity, it is suggested in the program that you help your child write a thank you letter for your local sanitation workers. So they are to dictate what you are to then write or assist them in writing. And then you are to wrap this up in an envelope and deliver it to your garbage collectors. Now, this almost worked out perfect because today is our garbage day. And you know, the garbage trucks going past around here, they're a big deal. Colton loves watching vehicles drive by out the front window, and the garbage trucks, they're big, they're loud. There's a few of them on the street at one time. So it's very exciting. The downside to this is I think they do our street first and they are here right at 7 o'clock in the morning. So here's the compromise to this for me, because there is no way that I'm going to make it outside at 7 a.m. with both of the kids, especially this time of year. It's still cold that early in the morning. So what we are going to do is we are going to glue our constructed garbage truck onto a bigger piece of paper and just write a much simpler thank you. Perhaps a thank you for keeping our community clean or something along those lines. And then next Friday, because the garbage men are long gone by now, we are going to hold this up in the window and then just give them a simple wave as we always do. And hopefully we have printed this large enough so that they can read it from the road. After we completed our activities for the day, that's when we got to our actual book. We watched this a few times through. And as we went through these different jobs, we again talked about the people we know that have some of these community jobs. And that is it for the day, and that is it for the week. Next week's will be a continuation of Community Helpers. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up or share it with somebody else you think might find this video helpful.